Andy Pandy.
Here comes Andy Pandy and Looby Loo. Happy as he can be, Teddy too. Playing in the garden every day, making things is so much fun.
Missy Hissy the snake had been to visit Looby Loo. On the way home, she heard a strange noise. It came from Andy Pandy's house. Andy was having breakfast, and he was making the strange noise. Andy told Missy Hissy that he hadn't got any milk to put on his cornflakes, and every time he chewed the flakes, they crackled. Missy Hissy told Andy about the jelly she'd had at Looby Loo's house. That had made strange noises. Andy wanted to hear Looby's noisy jelly for himself. Looby Loo's jelly made squelching noises. Looby asked Andy to make the jelly squelch. Crackling cornflakes and squelching jelly. Andy and Looby had never known food could be such fun. Looby wanted to go into the garden to find out if any other food made noises. Would an apple make a noise? Yes, it crunched. Looby had found some celery. That crunched as well, but it was a different sort of crunch. Teddy had heard the crunching, and Andy told him about the noisy food. Looby had an idea. They must all find as many different kinds of noisy food as they could, and that evening they'd meet for the noisiest supper in the world. Andy's biscuits were very noisy. But Teddy's honey didn't make any noise at all. Then he spread the honey on some toast. Toast and honey made a splendid noise. Andy's brown sauce made a slurping noise. When Looby peeled an orange, the peel ripped and the juice squirted. Andy was sure his crisps would make a lot of noise. And they did. What a feast Andy, Looby and Teddy were going to have. And what a noise it would make. Teddy had brought a drink, which made a very noisy fizz. Now they all tucked into their supper. Their supper was just as noisy as they'd hoped. In fact, their supper was so noisy, everyone else came to see what was going on. Missy Hissy was worried that Looby Loo might be in trouble, and they all went to see if she needed help. Looby told Missy Hissy about the noisy supper and asked everyone to come in. There was plenty for all. Everyone tucked in, but Teddy tucked in most of all. Everyone was full up, but Teddy was fullest of all. Later that night, Andy Pandy was fast asleep. But he was wakened by a very strange noise. Looby Loo had heard the noise too. It was coming from Teddy's house. The noise was inside Teddy's tummy. He'd had far too much to eat. Looby Loo's bag was full of useful things. She'd even got some tummy medicine. Teddy didn't like the sound of it. But Looby made him take the medicine anyway. Teddy felt better right away. Next morning, Andy Pandy came to see if Teddy was well again. Everything seemed very quiet. Teddy was having breakfast. He was eating a very small bowl of porridge, which made no noise at all. Andy was glad Teddy had learned his lesson. He must never be too greedy or too noisy.